Water, the central concern of our time. Wherever we live in the world today, whatever we do, we worry about where the water for the morrow is to come from. But while we worry, we forget to look around us at the bounty we are already blessed with. Have we done all we can to harness what we have to tackle an apparently insoluble problem? This film will tell you about very simple methods to address the problem of water. Low-cost methods that can easily be used by local people utilizing locally available natural resources as part of an overall strategy of watershed development. Rain in India falls with great intensity for a few hours on a few days in the monsoon months. When it rains, it really pours. Rainwater in this limited period largely flows away as heavy runoff. Watershed development involves a series of steps to stop this rainwater where it falls. To make it walk rather than run. To make it walk slowly below the ground. And not allow water to flow away rapidly over the terrain. This way, the same water becomes available for a longer period of time within the village. A watershed area can be visualized as a landscape, shaped unevenly like a bowl or basin. When it rains, water flows down from the top of this bowl to collect at the bottom. So the hills, valleys, forests and fields that encircle the falling rain and guide it to streams and rivers all form the enclosure that is the watershed, the catchment area where a river catches its water. Within a watershed, the slopes falling from the ridge are called the ridge area. The many channels that flowing rainwater drains into are called drainage lines. Woven into the contours of nature, watershed treatments aim to reduce the speed of runoff. These interventions are very location specific, varying with differences in slope, catchment, and soil. When running water is halted at regular intervals, it traps silt, reducing soil erosion. The local soil moisture profile also improves, providing greater sustenance to vegetation. Water that is stopped by watershed structures helps recharge of groundwater. Below the ground, this water appears as base flows that raise the water table in wells downstream. They also increase the life of streams and help refill dams more than once. Wells and dams become a sustainable source of irrigation in the village, greening landscapes and improving livelihoods. In this film, we are going to learn about boulder checks, a simple method of drainage line treatment. Boulder checks are very small dams made of loose rocks or boulders. They are made on small seasonal streams where the bed slope of the streams is less than 20% and their catchment area under 50 hectares. Each boulder check will not have a catchment area of more than 1 to 2 hectares. The main objective of constructing these rock dams is not so much to harvest rainwater, but to reduce the speed of flowing water through the stream. This helps reduce soil erosion and increases the duration of water flow in the stream. Boulder checks are made in the ridge area of the watershed. Since the slope of the stream where boulder checks are made needs to be less than 20%, our first task is to measure the slope of the streams in the ridge area. This can be done very easily by using a simple device called the pipe level. A pipe level consists of a transparent plastic pipe and two marked scales, each 2 meters in height. To measure the slope of the stream, one person stands with one of the scales at the lowest point of the stream bed, while the other person moves along the bed with the other scale. We then take the readings of the water level in each scale.
1:24.
1:15.
The difference between these two water levels is called the vertical interval between these two points. A measuring tape is used to arrive at the horizontal interval between the two points. The slope of the stream is the ratio of the vertical interval to to the horizontal interval.
नाली के सबसे निचले किनारे से हम बोल्डर चेक बनाना शुरू करेंगे. इसके लिए ये वाली साइड सबसे अच्छी है क्योंकि यहाँ पे किनारे पास पास हैं, मजबूत हैं और आसपास बोल्डर भी काफ़ी अवेलेबल हैं.
The height of boulder checks is generally kept at 1 meter. This can also be fixed with the help of the pipe level. We begin by drawing a center line across the stream at the site selected. Along the line, one of the scales of the pipe level is placed at the lowest point within the stream. The other scale is shifted towards the embankment till there is a vertical interval of 1 meter.
140
50
10 centimeter upar jao
121
26
aur upar khada aur
23 आ गया कोई ना.
हाँ, और ये निशान लगा रहे अभी
यहाँ. In the same way, the scale is taken to the other side, till again there is a vertical interval of 1 meter.
45 अशोक
145
तो बराबर 1 मीटर आ गए यहाँ पर. निशान लगा दे. लगा बस.
The top width of the boulder check is 40 centimeters. Two lines are drawn parallel to the center line, 20 centimeters on either side, to mark the top width. We then mark out the upstream and downstream slopes of the boulder check. The downstream slope is kept at 1:3. And the upstream slope 1:1. The downstream slope is deliberately kept more gradual to cushion the stream from the impact of the water that flows down from the top of the boulder check.
हमें boulder check का जो layout डालना है उसके लिए अब हम डंडे से नपटी करेंगे. जहाँ पर जितनी ऊंचाई आएगी boulder check की उसके हिसाब से पीछे की साइड में जो हमारा स्लोप 1:3 का होता है तो पीछे की साइड 3 डंडे नापेंगे और आगे की साइड 1:1 होता है तो आगे की साइड में 1 डंडा नापेंगे.
2 और ये 3. चल के ला डाल. कितना थोड़ा कम लग दे. चल
1
The process is repeated at a number of points of different height along the rope. This gives us a series of points that marks the layout of the boulder check. Area thus laid out must be excavated up to a depth of 25 centimeters to secure an adequate foundation for the boulder check. Now it is useful to make a frame outlining the slopes of the boulder check using sticks and strings.
चेक की ऊपर की चौड़ाई है और ये जो आप रस्सी देख रहे हैं ये इसके ढलान को मेंटेन करने के लिए है ताकि जब पत्थर इसमें जमाया जाए तो इसका आगे का ढलान अच्छी तरह मेंटेन किया जा सके और उसमें गलती भी ना हो। ये ढलान इस तरह से लिया जाता है कि जैसे एक मीटर ऊंचाई है तो ये एक मीटर इसका हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्टेंस है। इसी तरह पीछे की ओर देखेंगे तो ये एक ऊंचाई और तीन क्षैतिज दूरी, मतलब ये ढलान हुआ 1:3 का। उसी ढलान को प्रदर्शित करने के लिए और जब हम पत्थर जमा रहे हों आसानी से स्लोप को मेंटेन किया जा सके, उसके लिए ये रस्सी इस तरह से बांधी गई है दोनों ओर।
बोल्डर्स फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन आर कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम नियर द साइट। सर्टेन प्रिकॉशंस नीड टू बी टेकन व्हाइल कलेक्टिंग बोल्डर्स।
बोल्डर चेक बनाते समय एक विशेष सावधानी रखना चाहिए कि कभी भी नदी नाले के जो गोल पत्थर होते हैं उनका उपयोग बोल्डर चेक बनाने में नहीं करना चाहिए, क्योंकि इस तरह के यदि गोल पत्थरों का हम उपयोग करेंगे तो ये पत्थर हमारे बह के जाने की संभावना बहुत ज़्यादा होती है। बजाय इस तरह के गोल पत्थरों के बजाय हम यदि नुकीले पत्थरों का यदि उपयोग करें तो ज़्यादा बेहतर होगा। इस तरह के पत्थर एक दूसरे को पकड़ के रखते हैं जिससे हमारा बोल्डर चेक मजबूत बनता है और उसके बहने की संभावना नहीं रहती है। उसमें ऐसे जो छोटे छोटे पत्थर तुम्हारे हैं जिनका वजन 1 किलो से कम है उनको बिल्कुल काम में नहीं लेना है, ठीक है राम सिंह भाई? ऐसे छोटे छोटे पत्थर अगर जो तुम काम में लोगे ना तो ये बह जाएंगे, ठीक है ना, बारिश में। तो इसके बजाय अपन को बड़े बड़े पत्थर को काम में लेना है, ऐसे बड़े बड़े, इससे छोटा पत्थर नहीं लेना है काम में, है ना, बड़े बड़े, ठीक है रेनली? आगे ना समझ में?
अरे वो गाढ़ा हुआ पत्थर मत उठा, ऊपर ऊपर का पत्थर ले जाने का है, गाढ़ा हुआ पत्थर कभी मत उठा जो है नहीं, और बड़े बड़े पत्थर और छपटे छपटे है नहीं, गोल पत्थर मत ले जाओ।
Boulders embedded in the ground should never be dug out. That only increases possibilities of erosion. Always use loose boulders lying on the surface. The largest of the boulders must be placed on the outer sides. The dam should be built layer by layer. Boulders should be arranged in a way that they neatly fit into each other. The boulder check is embedded into each bank of the stream to give it firmness and stability. For this, we extend the check into the banks by digging trenches on either side of the check. Each embankment is raised 50 centimeters so that the boulder check has a distinct dip in the center. The extended edges are tied with 2 parallel ropes. A dip is created at the center of the boulder check by holding down the ropes with stones, thereby creating a slope towards the center. The ropes guide the placement of the boulders so that the slope is carefully maintained. Remember that unlike earthen dams, the boulder check is an overflow structure where water is allowed to flow over the top of the dam. It is therefore important to give a dip in the center of the boulder check so that water can safely pass over it. If the top of the boulder check is level, the flowing water will cut through the banks of the stream and break the boulder check. Because water is allowed to flow over the structure, the stream embankments have to be high enough to contain the flow of water within themselves. Therefore, the site for boulder checks should always have high and firm embankments. Boulder checks are most effective when they are made as a series on each small stream. The minimum vertical interval between two successive checks on a drainage line should equal the height of the structure so that the water temporarily stored in one check reaches the toe of the check immediately upstream. Any interval below this limit will not be cost effective. These boulder checks hardly cost a few thousand rupees, but their cumulative impact is truly remarkable. Built in the ridge area of a watershed, they check soil erosion and rejuvenate dried up streams, increasing the duration of their surface water flow. They also induce base flows that recharge downstream wells and water harvesting structures even after the monsoon.